We've featured some fabulous female chefs on Mela, but this week we thought it would be appropriate for one of your favorite men to pay a culinary tribute to the ladies. Here's Chef Dion Vengatass with a menu that's dedicated to all the inspiring and fearless women of the world, and it's cool, chic, and timelessly elegant.
Top of the morning to you, Dion.
Top of the day to you.
Dion, how do you create a menu that is timeless without it being boring?
I stick to some of the classical parameters and try not to move out of those parameters, and then we tweak it here or there to make it a bit modern or take a modern approach with it.
How do you add a modern twist to a classic?
It's just about smartly thinking about it, how you plate it, how you present it, adding one or two more flavorful things that can add to it or enhance it, but not really deteriorate from its original state.
What's on the menu today?
We have a few dishes that we have incorporated a lot of old classics into the restaurant, like the avocado Ritz. We've always had our famous beef Wellington available. I want to show you how we put it together. And then lastly, one of my favorite desserts, baked Alaska. It's a frozen dessert with a meringue on top of it, and it's burnt at the end. It's quite nice.
Let's get into it.
We're going to start with the avocado Ritz. Basically, just want to cut it in half. We're just going to peel the avocado and then lightly fan the avocado out just to lay them out neatly. And then lay your avocado inside of this mold. And then just carefully fan the avocado out so it's evenly spread out through the actual cutter. And then start off with your shredded lettuce and then some of your shallots. Then your prawns. Cut the prawns widthwise down the center so it's not such big pieces, okay, and it's more delicate as well. For the Russian meat sort of Mary Rose dressing, I've used one part mayonnaise, two parts tomato sauce, and then I've added a bit of horseradish in as well for that nice spiciness. Lots of finely diced shallots in there, some lemon, a bit of Tabasco, and a touch of brandy also. You just want to add enough dressing just to lightly coat your prawns. Just carefully move it around so that the lettuce is evenly redistributed and your shallots are also evenly redistributed. We just want to place the prawns inside of the actual mold. Lastly, I have the sauce vierge that I add to it. It's basically just a bit of olive oil that you temper in a pot on a medium heat. You add a bit of crushed coriander seeds, so it sizzles at the base of there, a bit of white pepper and black pepper ground. All of the flavors sort of distribute through the oil and carries that flavor throughout the actual sauce itself. Then I cut petals out of cocktail tomatoes and drop them in, and the seeds of the tomatoes are chopped very finely up. Add an equal quantity of lemon juice to the quantity of olive oil that I used. And to finish it off, I add lots of fresh coriander and parsley that's just roughly chopped, so you get that big textures and flavor of the actual herb when you bite into it. Don't be shy about the sauce here, because it honestly brings out that tomato. A bit of sunflower that I've shocked nicely, some pea shoots, and then the showstopper. Mm. Just to finish it off, you just want to add a little bit of lemon. It just brings everything out, and a touch of good al dente olive oil is what I use.
This Ritz is definitely elegantly timeless.
Such a beautiful, simple dish, provided it's good seasonal ingredients.
What's next, Dion?
Next, we're going to go over to the beef Wellington. We're going to start off with the beef fillet. I've just seared it off, got some beautiful caramelization. The ratio of how far you take your piece of meat is very important, because you don't want to leave your puff pastry in too long in the oven where it might burn or overcook. So once you've achieved what you want to have at the end result, you need to brush it with mustard. But very importantly, it's an English dish, so use English mustard. The flavor is completely different. The Dijon mustard is a bit more subtle. It's got a bit of spiciness to it, but not as much heat that the English mustard is. Literally smear it liberally all around a piece of meat. The next thing, you need a bit of cling wrap. It's gonna help shape and keep everything together as well. So the first thing we wanna do is get our pancake and lay it flat down onto the plastic wrap. The next step is to put your spinach down. The important thing about everything is balance as well, so you don't want to put too much of one ingredient. Next thing, we go with our macon, and we smoke it in now, so it's got a nice smoke of chicory wood chips that we use as well. And then we're going to go with our oxtail. So what I'm trying to do is layer the ingredients on top of the pancake, so when we cut through the actual Wellington, you can clearly see your outlined oxtail, your duxelle, your spinach around, and a beautiful fillet in the center with that macon that comes through.
Dion, it's like you're making a piece of art here.
Something like that. There we go with our duxelle now. Very importantly, it's nice and dry and there's enough jam-packed flavor inside of it. Classically, the duxelle is one of the ingredients that must be inside of your Wellington. Lastly, your fillet, which we've rubbed liberally with the mustard. Mm-hmm. What you need to do here is roll a little bit and then pull it tight again. Just try not to get any plastic inside, because it might end up in your Wellington once you roll it in the puff pastry. So just be very mindful and careful about that. Go. So once your fillets rolled in the pancake, tie a knot around it. You can use anything that will aid in tying it up together. The best thing to do is to leave it in the freezer for about 20 minutes because it firms up and makes it much more easier and pliable to roll into the puff pastry later. Let's just put this on the side while we roll our puff pastry. Okay, so just get a bit of flour on there. When you're rolling out, it's very important to sort of keep your body weight over your actual rolling pin so you add pressure onto it. And I mean, I can do this with my eyes closed because we were rolling roti for the aunties when we were like little kids already. Just turn it the other way around from the center out. We're trying to form a rectangle. Just make sure that it's even as well because you don't want uneven puff pastry in your Wellington once it's rolled or else it's not going to cook evenly. Once you have your puff pastry rolled out, you just want to sort of unravel your Wellington that you've rolled in the pastry. Just cut the edges off. When unrolling it, just keep it on the edge of where you're going to actually roll your Wellington in so it falls on with the last sort of wrap. Get some of your egg wash. I also don't want to put too much because if I have too much in between the layers, it sort of also coagulates when you're cooking it. Okay. And then there's this unpleasant pieces of sort of hard pastry. You want to start off with your edges first and gently bring them to the center, pulling the base of it over so you get that one motion around it. And then just tuck in the edges in over here. Trim all of this out now. We just want to get a little bit of egg wash on the end where we're going to connect it. And then it's literally just connecting over here. And that's it.
Okay.
Keep the shape of your Wellington and cut all the excess off. Just make sure that your connection is at the base. The score lines is very important. You just want to gently sort of score it. I use a palette knife so it doesn't actually cut into it. And the reason for scoring it is because when you cook your puff pastry, it stretches. If you don't score it, it's sort of going to stretch and pull away and it might cause holes in your actual Wellington. Very importantly now, a bit of your egg wash on top of it to get a beautiful golden brown finish. Very, very importantly, the cooking process. Preheating your oven up to 200 degrees Celsius is very important. Make sure that your oven maintains that temperature for at least 10 minutes before we start adding anything inside of the oven. Once you get your oven to 220 degrees, get an oven tray that fits into your oven with nothing on it and pop it inside of your oven. Once it's preheated and your tray is super hot, you take your actual Wellington and you place it directly onto that hot tray with the connected side at the base. The reason for this is the hot tray that's at the bottom in your oven starts cooking the base of your Wellington. And then the top also gets evenly cooked. Then I cook it for 15 minutes. I allow it to rest for 10 minutes before cutting it. If you don't allow it to rest, all of those mandrels that have been cooking through the process, some that have soaked into the actual pancake, will all get released. So when you give it time to retract back into the piece of meat, and it gives you this beautiful pink, medium rare, rested fillet.
The best for last.
Dessert!
Yay!
Your favorite dessert, which is the baked Alaska. The layers of the dessert itself is three different ice creams. It has a meringue that's piped on the outside of it and the meringue is burnt. You got your meringue, so you just gotta add your egg whites, a bit of sugar and a touch of vinegar. The vinegar sort of stabilizes it and keeps it firm for a longer time. And then you just gotta whip it with a whisk attachment until it forms stiff peaks. So it's literally just piping it all around the actual ice cream. Then you just wanna sort of blowtorch the entire thing.
Dion, that looks dangerous.
And what we do in the restaurant, we normally burn a flammable liquid.
Ah, as a showstopper.
Yes. So once it's lit, you basically just pour a little bit over.
Oh, you can see the flame.
That's the dessert. I think that Wellington should be ready by now. Let me go and grab it.
I would say et voila, but it's an English dish. What should we say?
It's quite pleasant.
How delightful.
How delightful it is. What you're going to do is get this baby onto your cutting board. Mm-hmm. Just remember this entire layer here is basically puff pastry, so you just want to cut that first layer off.
Look at those layers.
That's what I was talking about.
Dion, thank you so much for all the tips and tricks and the amazing meals.
Are you much obliged? It's been such a pleasure cooking these classics. After you.
Obviously, best first. There's a reason I love dessert, and you for making it.
Oh, thank you so much.